Once upon a time, in Osaka, Japan, lived a boy whose father was Japanese while his mother was Australian. And nobody ever imagined that one day this boy would become the famous YouTuber, singer, and rapper known as Joji, or his past, Filthy Frank. But how did Joji and Filthy Frank become a famous YouTuber, singer, and rapper? And why did he become a YouTube singer and rapper? Is it true that he has 7 different alter egos on YouTube? Can he breakdance? And why does he post so much offensive content? Does he have many abilities? What was his life like before? It's time for me to answer all these questions and more. Since this is ASMR, Aaron, back at it again with another daily video to help you relax. So lay back and enjoy the ride. I hope this video gets you through your day, or even better, I hope this read helps you gently fall asleep. I can't wait to get started.
This is the tale of Joji, aka Filthy Frank.
George Kusunoki Miller was born on September 18, 1992, in Osaka, Japan. During his birth, his Australian mother and Japanese father were there in Japan for work reasons. He attended an international school, Canadian Academy in Kobe, Japan, where he graduated in 2012. At age 18, he left Japan and traveled to the United States. He is half Japanese and half Australian. Filthy Frank's career as a YouTuber began in a rather odd way. He had placed a bet against his friend, saying he would upload a video with offensive content and still get loads and loads of views. Keeping his words, Filthy Frank uploaded a video on YouTube where he talked about explosive diarrhea. Surprisingly, the video collected 10,000 views in a very short while. Feeling encouraged and confident, he made his own YouTube channel, Disaster Music, uploading not-so-conventional filthy videos, thus the name Filthy Frank. Following series of copyright issues for music used in his videos and a risk of losing his YouTube channel for use of foul words and phrases, with almost 1 million subscribers, he opened a new YouTube channel named TV Filthy Frank. His new channel, TV Filthy Frank, did vary a little from his primary channel in terms of content. Nevertheless, the viewers loved him. Soon enough, his channel had crowded with over 6 million subscribers. The fame of Filthy Frank started to boom when he launched his popular YouTube channel called TV Filthy Frank. With his new channel, Filthy Frank selected an alternate route to create his brand image. His new videos were based on himself and other imaginary creatures living in his house. Filthy Frank was the central character of these videos, which hunts down the ghosts living in his house. With the tremendous success enjoyed by his content, Filthy Frank has proved that any person with innovative ideas and snazzy content can quickly get popular and gain a large fan following on the internet. In view of the growing popularity of his channel, Filthy Frank started to position himself in a very unique manner. He likes to call himself as being antisocial, anti-PC, and anti-couth. Filthy Frank started his own website in order to properly showcase his content. In the year 2014, he created a sub-channel for content that is too offensive for his regular viewers. The sub-channel is called Too Damn Filthy, and contains some of the worst content available on the internet. To his own surprise, and that of his fans, the content posted on this sub-channel too got very popular. Filthy Frank made a mark on his fans by cleverly differentiating himself from similar artists. He tries to be as realistic as possible in his videos. Rather than recording his bizarre videos behind closed doors, he liked to perform in public spaces. He never shows any inhibition in doing bizarre things in his videos. In some videos posted on his website, he is shown to be crawling on the streets and floors of restaurants. These acts make his videos very appealing to his fans. However, the most important reason that makes Filthy Frank so special is that he criticizes all kinds of evils in the society. Despite being vulgar, Filthy Frank's content tries hard to highlight the stupidity of racism, injustice to women, and misogyny. Filthy Frank does not only create content for YouTube, he is also a musical artist and is increasingly gaining popularity in this area on top of YouTube stardom. Frank takes this field seriously and comedically. He makes independent music and can be found on SoundCloud under the name Joji. However, he is most popular in the field of music as Pink Guy and dabbles in rap music with ridiculous, crude lyrics he makes for the show and its comedic effect. Under Pink Guy, two albums have been released thus far. These albums are self-titled Pink Guy and the most recent Pink Season, which contains a whopping 35 songs. Although there is a tremendous amount of offensive subject matter, Frank is actually a talented music producer making catchy beats and melodies. To offer perspective on the attractiveness and popularity of the music from Pink Guy, the album Pink Season reached the top of the iTunes charts, was the most downloaded album on Apple Music, and reached number 70 on the Billboard 200. Pretty crazy, huh? A crude musician wearing a pink morph suit reaching top-tier recognition on iTunes. It has gotten to the point where Pink Guy is becoming a musical phenomenon as he now conducts live performances. Recently, he did a live set in Austin, Texas, and there are talks for a Pink Guy tour, which will undoubtedly boost Frank's popularity even further. It is very apparent that loads of people enjoy Pink Guy's weird, crude, yet oddly enjoyable music if fans want a tour to happen. One fan who commented on the live performance in Texas had this to say. He's still talented as fuck. He is a master of the cringe and political incorrectness. Filthy Frank is rocketing towards high celebrity status because of his well-received dark comedy and musical talent. In a 2005 interview with fellow YouTuber The Needle Drop, Miller talks about the off-kilter persona he has created that can be seen throughout all his video skits. He's so over the top with his shit, it's impossible to take it seriously, and that's the point, Miller said. I'm kind of making fun of racism and all that by being overly racist with this character. The fun part is when people don't get it. Miller re-emphasized that Filthy Frank by no means represents any of his beliefs, but he understands the mixed reactions of people who stumble across his strange content. He has created a controversial figure that represents the comment stalkers and trolls lurking in the depths of YouTube. Inadvertently, this attracts the very trolls he is trying to parody, as can be seen in the comment section of all his videos. Moreover, his YouTube bio reaffirms the satiric tones his channel consists of. Filthy Frank is the embodiment of everything a person should not be. He is anti-PC, anti-social, and anti-couth, said Miller. He behaves and reacts excessively to everything expressly to highlight the ridiculousness of racism, misogyny, legalism, injustice, ignorance, and other social blights. Due to getting famous by posting bizarre videos on his YouTube channel, Filthy Frank has courted controversies due to a number of reasons. Some critics point out that some of his videos cross the boundaries. In the year 2014, Filthy Frank uploaded a video called Disaster Music. The video immediately courted controversy as one media company complained that it violated copyright due to the music used for it. Moreover, in the video, Filthy Frank broke the character and revealed to the viewers that he had a major brain condition that periodically gives him seizures. Due to this condition, he argued that he needs to frequently slow down while performing in his shows. After the video was published, his fans and critics alleged that Filthy Frank was using his personal issues like ill health to gain more publicity. The video was later removed from his channel. Moreover, each and every video posted on his YouTube ends with the phrase, "Let us get some pussy tonight." Critics opine that he can do away with such vulgar-sounding phrases. Filthy Frank is currently single. He also hasn't mentioned any relationship and affairs about his previous girlfriend or fling. On December 29th, 2017, Miller released a statement on Twitter explaining that he had stopped producing comedy, including Filthy Frank, due to both serious health conditions and his personal lack of interest in continuing the series. Popular videos are Pink Guy, STFU. Frank dedicates this video to all his acquaintances and asks them to leave him alone. 100 Accurate Life Hacks. He sets on a journey to find the most efficient life hacks. Weeboos. He settles the weeboo epidemic once and for all. Best of Pink Guy. It is a collection of his fun activities. And so ends the tale of the famous YouTuber Filthy Frank, or Joji, who lived happily ever after, but his fans miss him and his weird taste for fun.
Thank you.